Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. Relay is a device that has electromagnet in it, and when it receives a voltage, either DC or AC, it energizes and moves the contact from one position to the other position, either connecting or disconnecting one or multiple connections. In this case, we are using 5 volts battery to control an AC bulb, which is maybe 110 or 220 volts, depending on the region that you live. So you can use 5 volts Arduino or other means to turn on and off this relay, and subsequently turn on and off an AC load or maybe very high current, let's say 10 ampere air conditioner or something. So in this case, the relay needs 5 volts, and this is the battery. It comes through the switch, which is currently off, and the current is not completed. Once we switch this, the current establishes, and the contact which was in here, it goes down. When it goes down, this is connected to the wall. The current which was disconnected before now comes and passes through this, and the light turns on. And the benefit of using relay is that this can be 220 volts, 110 volts, whatever voltage, maybe due to safety, amount of power or other reasons, you're just isolating it and using it and controlling it with 5 volts. Electronically or electrically, these two are not connected. How it works is that we have an iron core or other cores, and there is a wire wound around this, and there are two sides of this wire. How it works is that we have an iron core and there is a winding of wire. This is insulated, and when you connect these two sides to a battery or a power, the magnetic field intensifies and this create magnetic field around it. This is electromagnet. It has a winding around it, and this is my battery. I'm connecting it to the battery. Now this is magnet. Because it is working with electricity, we call it electromagnet. And as you can see, it pulls the plier. And if I disconnect this power, you will see that it will release. This is another type of electromagnet. This is called solenoid, and electromagnet will pull this internally too, so this can be used to open the door lock or push something or move a valve to release liquid or something. Connected now to the power. So this is electromagnet. Same thing is inside the relay. The relay module that we are using is this one, which has this relay installed on it. And this is called now module because it has other components and can be connected with other stuff. And it has some transistor and other component, which is called the relay driver. And it just makes it easy for us. Inside this, we have electromagnet. This is a relay from a car or some other devices that have. It has a magnet, and on this side it will pull this piece, this from the bottom. When it pulls it, that piece will move the other way. And as you can see, in here, it connects and disconnects the contact, which the wires will be connected in here. And this is exactly what happens when you connect the switch. This gets magnetized and pushes this down, and the connection establishes at this point, and the light will turn on.
And I'm going to use this AC bulb. This is a plug that will be connected to wall outlet, and the light will be turned on. At the middle, at this point, I have disconnected the wire, one of the wire, the live wire here, and I've twisted them and prepared them. These two will be connected to the relay. Job of relay is to turn it on by connecting these two wires, turning on the light, and disconnecting it, turning it off. So this can be a bulb or a fan or any other load, the same way the relay will connect it and disconnect it.
Relay is being used very widely in different applications, different ways, and this is another example that relay have been used with this timer controller that you can set the time. For example, you can say it should be turned on for 2 seconds and turn off for 6 seconds, or turn on for when you turn the device on initially, it will be turned off for 3 minutes and turn on for 8 minutes, or depending on a voltage, this can take action. So this is one way. Or you will see the relay, and this is dual relay, two relays in one module, and you can control it with Arduino or other means to control a load. The AC or DC load, light or anything that you control is called load. So we can control load using this module, two loads, or you can see we might be able to use 4, 8, even 16 relay will be available to be used. Let me explain the relay module. The relay has 3 pins here for AC load, and this has been labeled in Chinese, but you might also get the same module with English. These 2 pins are called normally closed, so they are connected normally, and here also they put the drawing for these two, and these two are normally closed when there is no power. And when there is power, then this will go to the other side and this pin will be connected there, which means this will be connected to this. When you connect your load or whatever you want to control, the two wires that you put will be in here, so that when the relay is energized, these two will get connected and your device or load, whatever you have, will be turned on. Then we have here 3 pins. This is labeled as N, the input signal that controls this. And this is the ground. This will be connected to the ground of Arduino. This is VCC, this is 5 volts. And the relay has been labeled here as 5 volts. So you will connect it to 5 volts. There are 2 other LEDs. This LED is the power. When you connect it to the ground and VCC, this will let and will let you know that there is power, and this will turn on green, or will turn on when the signal comes here, and this will turn on. There are 2 types of relay modules. The relay that receives a positive or high at the input to turn on, it's called high trigger, and the relay that receives low and will turn on, it's called low trigger. This is the low trigger, meaning this should receive 0 in order to turn on the relay. When this is high or 5 volts, this will go off. So keep that in mind, that this is the opposite. This is called low trigger. When you work with relay, pay attention to the rating of the relay. For example, this relay is 5 volts, and the rating of current or amount of load that this can control is written here. For example, in 250 volts AC, or let's say 220, it can handle 10 ampere, at 30 volts also 10 ampere, 120. In all voltages, this can handle 10 ampere. How you relate it to the power is that you multiply the voltage by the current. So 10 times 250, just put 10, this is 2500 watt. So it can handle a 2.2 kilowatt or 2500 watt load if you're using 250 volts. If you're using 220 volts, a load times 10 will be 2200 or 2.2 kilowatt. If you're in North America and you're using 120 volts, then times 10 will be 1200 watt or 1.2 kilowatt. If you overload this, the contacts will melt and it might cause fire. It will be very dangerous, so pay attention to that. If you want to control a load with higher power, then use appropriate relays to control those type of loads. Let me explain now the wiring.
And I'm going to use this AC bulb. This is a plaque that will be connected to wall outlet and the light will be turned on. The middle, at this point, I've disconnected the wire, one of the wire, the live wire here, and I've twisted them and prepared them. These two will be connected to the relay. Job of relay is to turn it on by connecting these two wire, turning on the light, and disconnecting it, turning it off. So this can be a bulb or a fan or any other load, the same way the relay will connect it and disconnect it.
These two wires are from the AC bulb that is connected in here at these two pins. The last pin is empty. Here is the wiring diagram, and you can use AC or DC load. I'm using AC bulb here as an example. The two right side, if we put the relay module like this, the two wires will go to the two wires that we cut from the power that goes to the bulb. And from here, the right pin is the in. This is connected to pin 2. The middle pin is the ground, connected to the ground, and the left pin is the VCC, which goes to 5 volts. And on this side, and then here, the red VCC is connected to 5 volts of Arduino. The middle one, brown, is connected to the ground, and the input pin, the in pin, is a yellow wire connected to pin 2 of Arduino. Let me now explain the code. The first line that I've used, I've defined a pin for relay, and we call it relay pin. P is capital here, and in Arduino, lower and uppercase matters. So when you use this, you have to copy and paste it and make sure the P is capital. And I've defined it as a type integer, integer relay pin, and assigned 2 to this value. Now this means everywhere I use this, this will be as if I type 2. You can change this to any other digital pin that you wish. Inside the setup, we use pin mode relay pin as an output. Relay pin is 2. So pin 2 is now as an output. And after that, this is a loop. Starts from here to here. And the this loop runs continuously after executing this code. The first line here, it says digital write. And it writes to the relay pin, which is 2. It writes low signal. It sends 0 volt. And then waits for 3 seconds or 3000 milliseconds. Now pin 2 is low, and our relay will turn on. After that, pin 2 will be high using digital write, and we wait 1 second. And then the loop comes back here, and again, relay will turn on for 3 seconds and turn off for 1 second, and continuously doing this. I've connected it. The relay is on. Once you connect this to the wall, do not touch this, because this is a very dangerous area, and I will not touch this. As you can see, when the green is on, the LED is on, the light is on, and you can also hear the click. On time is 3 seconds and off time is 1 second. That's why if you want to turn it on quickly, let's say 100 milliseconds on and 100 milliseconds off, or 1 second on, 4 seconds off. As soon as you see the blank here, the code will be uploaded. So 4 seconds off and 1 second on. This was how to use relay and control an AC or DC load. Any load you wish to connect, you can connect it to the relay and control it, as long as you pay attention to the rating.
Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.